not fire. That would be the ultimate in suffering. Hell is mud.
Hi guys, and welcome to our weekly Wednesday Winter Winter What Models We Painted this week in Under the Brush. But this week, it's once more time to look at not just the what we've done, but also the how. This time around, it's a long neglected series of ours. Quick and dirty modelling. And we are turning our attention to a way of doing chalky mud, such as can be found in numerous work sites, as well as on the battlefield. The inspiration for this came when I saw a dug up old steel pipe left out by a demolition site on the way to work, and I knew I wanted to recreate something similar. As it happens, I was doing some Death Guard and terrain for 40k, and so I thought I would try it out on these particular models. This was more of an experiment rather than something I had specifically done before, so I ended up combining a few techniques into a single process. I will let you, dear viewer, judge the results for yourself. I began with some PVA wood glue to use as a binding agent, which I mixed in with some dirty paint water in a roughly 50-50 or 40-60 ratio. Once this was mixed up, it was time to mix in the baby powder to create a slurry. I have used clean water, PVA, and baby powder before when creating fine powdery snow, and also baby powder alone, like a weathering powder, to do surfaces that are very, very dusty. But this is my first time trying it as a base for mud. I used a darker brown from Tamiya as it was closer hand, and also mixed in a redder brown so that the earthy colour was not all one uniform colour. The red is there to hint at the clay deposits in the earth. As you'll see, I did not fully mix it, and this was to try and preserve this lack of uniformity. The whiteness of the talcum powder, I mean the baby powder, will cause the colour to pale as it dries. So that is why I went for a darker colour to compensate. Arguably, an even darker colour still would probably work even better. Next came the fun bit, applying it. I started on the tracks of my Plague Burst crawler. These would press into the mud and really get enveloped in its cloying wetness. And so I started by applying the most watery portion of the mixture I'd made and pressing it smooth to try and replicate this motion of the tracks running over wet mud. Over the chassis, the tracks would kick up and splatter mud, and thus my painting movements were more akin to stippling to represent that. Elsewhere on the model too, such as the wheels driving the tracks and the underworkings and arms supporting the dozer blade, a lot of the reach of the mud would be due to it either being carried around by the tracks and deposited in nooks and crannies, or being thrown there by the movement of the tracks as it went along. And so I tried to apply the mud mixture with that in mind as I moved my brush, similar to how one paints on canvas with oils as it happens. Next, to represent looser bits drying and dropping off, I went in with some tissue and dabbed certain areas. Additionally, as this model is not attached to a base, it necessitated a slightly thinner coverage of mud than I'd otherwise do, as I will be constantly handling it by the model itself rather than by its base. Once this is done, I then let it dry, although I was not finished yet. Next, I poured the remainder of the mixture into a small plastic lid to reduce its surface area to slow its drying, and prepared a set of pipes I wanted to do for terrain. I found sets of three of these in a local 100 yen shop, the equivalent to a dollar store or a pound shop or whatnot. My thinking with painting these was, as they were once underground pipes, they would have been buried and then dug up, so I tried to keep the application of the mixture wet to try and recreate rain, subsequently washing off the heavier clots of mud before drying it out in the sun. By this point, the mud on the tank had dried, and so it was time to go in with the dry brush, using the redder brown, just to give it a little bit more visual interest. This effectively gave three layers of colour to the mud, red earth on top, with a paler brown below, and the paler chalkier talcum powder depositing in the recesses. I then did the same on the pipes, going a little heavier with the red, as rust would no doubt be mixed in with the mud here. Finally, to finish, I went over the model with a satin finish. This was just to give the colours a little bit more moisture to their look, as opposed to my usual matte finish. Overall, this was a very interesting experiment. I don't know if it was successful, but it was interesting. If you try out anything from this video, or like this, or have any ideas, I'd love to hear them. Feel free to drop them in the comments. We are always open to new ideas and constructive thinking. Well, that's it. Until November's painting tutorial, hopefully. But you can follow our painting progress here every Wednesday and on Instagram. If you have any requests to see how I tackle any particular model or an army, please also leave that in a comment. Thanks for watching and enjoy your hobbying.